Paramesh Bheem Reddy, president of American Telugu Association, which is known as ATA. So the ATA established 30 years ago in America for the people of Telugu origin. The language could be anything. And so we are, today we are here for conducting educational seminar to bringing awareness for the students who wants to go for abroad studies, particularly for America. In the last two years back also, we did educational tour, educational seminars in the last 2 years ago. In December month, we went around in Telangana districts for various universities, for Palamur University, Mahatma Gandhi University, Telangana University, all these universities, and we were giving the overview of abroad studies. But eventually at the end, we realized that that circuit lectures may not be a good idea. So next year, we wanted to do one single seminar, and then we spoke with the Telangana Higher Education Commission and Paparedi Garu, Venkatramana Garu, the time, and they suggested to hold in one place, and they will coordinate with us. And that time, and we entered into a memorandum of understanding. And so this was because, you know, recently the many people, recent years, many students coming to US because of the you know, booming of engineering colleges, lacks of graduates, guys are graduating in colleges and they want to go to, you know, abroad studies, you know, because of the lack of opportunities here as well as the higher educational. You know, it is very tough for you to get into the master's program here by taking the GATE, and GATE is still GATE, I don't know. It used to be GATE exam to get into the master's, right? So it was much more easier for people to go to higher education in America and sought a better education, you know, world-class institutions. And but recently I went to 30 years back. That time we didn't have much information, but still we chose better colleges to attend. But nowadays we meet so many students and they go to so much of remote places, and we never have heard about those colleges. Those, many of those colleges are for-profit colleges. They really, they do not look for your giving a better education. Their whole goal is to make money. So it is very important for you guys to do your homework when you are choosing the college. So, and this is a continuous process, and we will bring awareness to the students here. And we will work with Telangana Higher Education and other US consulate, and we will conduct more of these seminars. And also in ATA, as Paparedi Garu said, we they need a 1-800 number for students. We have 1-800 number for all the help, whoever needs the help in America. We have 1-800 number, they can call us. We are there to help. And also we established a free membership for students. Generally, the taking the membership in the American Telugu Association is $100, but we made it free for students. Whoever comes there as an international student, they can enroll for free as a member, so they can be in the loop and you can be in touch with us. And also, the important, maybe mind-boggling question for you might be, is it America is the same as before, or things change after Trump taking over, and is it good to go, or instead of I should go to some other country? Maybe these are questions boggling you. But I would say there's nothing changed. America is still the best country for you to pursue. There are the world-class institutions you can't find any other place, and much more easier, much more liberal. They are much more accommodative American universities. And do not follow, do not read too much of news here. They make sensationalized the TV channels as if, you know, almost you will be you are kicked out of America, there's nothing, you know, people are suffering. Those all crap. This is much more better. Still nothing changed for the students who does well in their academics. they go to better schools, they have better opportunities, and they excel. But only the problem with the low end, who doesn't have better scores, better GPA, and choosing and going to this creepy colleges in remote places, you shouldn't be looking into that. And yeah, that's all I can tell you. And if you have any other questions, we will do more interactive session. And we will be more than happy to answer your questions. And Rajshekhar, thank you for giving this opportunity. Also, just like you, 27 years ago, I did my BTEC and I went to USA in 1992. I heard you are from 30 different colleges here, right? And you all want to go to US. It's a good choice. Thank you, Mr. Eric Alexander, for your valuable information. I am from ATA, American Telugu Association. ATA is a premier Indo-American organization helping our communities since 1990. We work with students and we will work with you. Nothing to worry. It's all simple process, but take proper guidance and be safe. That's about it. ATA has members of all walks of life, professors, scientists, business people, doctors, and engineers. And I'm proud to be one of them. And thank you, ATA, for giving me opportunity. And thank you, Telangana Council of Higher Education, to work with us. And thank you, US Consulate General, to work with us and to help our communities. All you need is a proper homework. I don't want to repeat again about how to choose right colleges, what is the application process, getting I-20, getting a visa, and how to choose right colleges. We are there to work with you. Send us an email, atahelp@ataworld.org, or our website, americantelugu association.org. We'll work with you, we'll support you. We do provide information through webinars, through emails, through one-on-one phone calls, anyway. Because we know the problems. We've been through this. So no big deal. So there is no shortcut to the success. Let's go step by step and let's reach our goals. And I wish you all the very best, and we are with you. Thank you. Finally,
thank you, Bhuvanesh Bijala. Next, I request one of the ATA members.
Thanks to all the dignitaries on the stage. First of all, I like to make a comment. It's such a heartening thing that so many lady students are in the auditorium. Wow! Especially the minority lady students. And it, I cannot forget to say that if you are pursuing to come to the US, the United States is the fairest and most inclusive society in the world. So you have chosen the best, you know, path to go there. So I don't want to take too long to make the speech, but you know, this would be a continuous dialogue. This is not a one-time thing. ATA will continue to partner with the state Higher Education Council and the U.S. Consulate to provide these things. And we look forward to the sessions, the second session, where Professor Rajshekhar and the folks from the consulate will provide you some more details, tips. You know, one thing what you know, Chief of Council has mentioned, and I would say as a business person in the United States, I would emphasize is, you know, there are no shortcuts in the U.S. And it is, you have to be very transparent, you should always tell the truth, and if you do those things, it's almost guaranteed that you can succeed in the United States. So wish you the best of luck. We are always there if you need any support. Thank you.
President of today's session, Professor T. Papireddy Garu, Chairman, Telangana State Council of Higher Education, and Mr. Eric Alexander, the Council General of U.S. Consulate in Hyderabad, and Mr. Paramesh Bheem Reddy Garu, President of American Telugu Association, and Mr. Bhuvanesh, President-elect American Telugu Association, and Mr. Jayadev Chella, Board of Trustees, ATA, and Professor Rajshekhar Garu, ATA Education Committee Member, and Madam Kavita Garu, Telangana Development Forum Chairman in US, and distinguished guests, and Mr. Jafar Javid Garu, who is the secretary of this prestigious institute, and students who are participating in this seminar, and members of the press. It's a great privilege for me, and I'm delighted to be here today on the occasion of holding this education seminar by American Telugu Association in association with the Telangana State Council of Higher Education. And all the distinguished guests, they have expressed their opinion on the intention of holding this seminar today. And the subjects chosen by the organizers in the session 1 and session 2 are very interesting. How to select the US colleges and universities, and the mode of university application, and getting I-20 and the steps to apply for US visas to the students, and they can post questions and they get answers from the distinguished guests who are here. And also for the college and the university administration, there are some points to be debated here today, that is regarding the digitization of the student records, articulation agreements between Indian and US colleges and universities, with regard to dual degree programs, faculty exchange programs, student exchange programs, and other team teaching opportunities available for the students in Telangana. These are the subjects which you are going to discuss in the session 1 and 2 today. In fact, Mr. Alexander, the US Consulate General, he had already extended the necessary help by way of agreeing to the provide the complete information about the methodology, process, and the steps in applying for the US universities. It's great help indeed, Mr. Alexander, which I think today's seminar will be a fruitful discussion today, because the steps and the way of the methodology, the students had to get the information that already the members of the ATA, they are going to share with you. I think every one of you should participate in this seminar, and you should ask questions and get the necessary answers from the distinguished guests who are available here. This is what I want from the students who gathered here. They have to share their opinions without mincing words, because this is a very good opportunity for all of you to get the better, best information, rather than you getting from the internet and the other way of information which is available to you. Just I would like to inform all of you that Telangana is a new state. I think during the agitation period, all of you were just school going children, because now you are in engineering students. But for the last 14 years, way back in 2001, we started the agitation for a separate statehood of Telangana. The reason is very simple. In Telugu, we have coined a word, a phrase that is Neelu, Nidulu, Niyamakalu. Neelu means water, Nidulu means the availability of funds for the development of our state, the region then, and Niyamakalu means employment. So this is a subject which now we are going to discuss, debate here in this seminar. Niyamakalu means employment. Employment doesn't need, it's only government employment. It is how you are going to get educated and how you are going to make your livelihood in future. This is one of the point which we have raised in the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh. The first part, that is Neelu, that is water. Yes, I am proud to say today from this dais that we have achieved the water share of our region then in the state of Telangana. Both the rivers, that is Godavari and Krishna, the mighty rivers, though they are not perennial rivers, definitely they are mighty rivers. So the water which is available in these two rivers, yes, now under the leadership of our Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, commonly we mention him as KCR, yes, we are constructing mighty projects on both these rivers, that is River Godavari and River Krishna. Yes, we are assuring the farming community in our new state. In the coming days, we are going to give water for 1 crore acres in our state, which is available for irrigation. Yes, whatever land is available for irrigation, we are going to irrigate those lands with the water available in both these rivers. I think many of your, the students who gathered here might be pursuing civil engineering. I think the institution should definitely take them to these two projects which are constructing on River Godavari, that is Kaleshwaram project. Not only the civil engineering graduates, even the electrical engineering graduates pursuing engineering studies, you should go and see. Because the pumps and motors we have installed in Lakshmipuram tunnel is the largest pump in the world. The surge pool which we have constructed near Midmaner project is one of the deepest surge pool in the world. Yes, you have to go and see it. So within a span of 4-5 years, the government of Telangana took initiative and we have constructed and constructing some more projects on these two rivers. And today, you know that power, we have not gone in detail about the applications. There were some errors, but now the policy makers have taken a decision that who are meritorious. Students who are opting for good universities abroad, it may be US, UK, Australia, Singapore, whatever country it may be, even in Europe, there are good universities in Germany and France also. So the students who are opting for admissions in those universities, the government of Telangana is ready to support them. And last year, I think just now Mr. Srinivas Gaur has mentioned that we have given around 3,000 scholarships for the young students who want to pursue higher education abroad. So now Mr. Alexander, the Consul General in Hyderabad Consulate, he had mentioned that there are good opportunities in US, and my request would be those students who want to go abroad and pursue their education, and after pursuing their education, they should come back. And it should not be a brain drain for the state of Telangana. My request would be, definitely you have to pursue your education and you have to go there, study, do some research work, and you should come back to the state of Telangana and see that Telangana state prosper. And before concluding, I would like to request the ATA members on the dais and also the Telangana State Council of Higher Education members, because in collaboration and in association with the government, they are conducting this seminar, and I would like them to conduct such seminars in the erstwhile district headquarters such as Warangal, Karimnagar, Nizamabad, Khammam, Mahbubnagar and Nalagonda also, because there are some underprivileged students in the rural areas, because the first generation, second generation, third generation literate families, yes, they do have connections abroad, and those family members will suggest them. So immediately after passing intermediate, after joining in such prestigious institutions like this, you think of how to pursue your graduation and where to apply, how to apply, and all this information is shared by your family and your friends. But there are some students who are bright enough to pursue their education, but unfortunately there is no information to them. They are underprivileged. They can't think of their education elsewhere, abroad. So the distinguished guests on the dais, my request with you would be, we have to strengthen them. We have to give confidence to such students who are in the rural areas, more particularly from the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, most backward class community in our society. Because the Telangana demography, if you go into detail, 86% of the population in Telangana, they are from the backward class communities. Except Jharkhand and Telangana, such huge population among the underprivileged is not seen. If you go to Uttar Pradesh, the farmer class community is around 20-25%. But whereas in Telangana, the underprivileged sections of the society, the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, backward class, minority students are about 89%. In the Sri Krishna Committee report, during the agitation time, a committee was constituted under the leadership of Justice Sri Krishna. He submitted a report to the Government of India wherein he had mentioned that the population demography of this region, now our state of Telangana, is as follows. He has mentioned about each community's and that compounds to 89%. So my request with the members of ATA and also the Telangana State Council of Higher Education is that yes, we should conduct such seminars in the erstwhile district headquarters, at least. Not, we can't conduct such type of seminars in each district headquarters, I know it, but at least in the erstwhile district headquarters we should conduct, and we should sensitize the students. We should sensitize the students so that they get confidence and they can pursue their education during their maybe in medicine or engineering or in social sciences, whatever it may be, during their graduation time they can well informed, or they can get confidence so that they can pursue higher education in US. I think with these few suggestions, and once just now I requested Mr. Alexander that in the coming session of Parliament, hopefully the new education policy will be declared officially, and there is a opinion among the academic fraternity that Indian Parliament should pass the bill which is pending for the last one decade. This is with regard to the foreign universities, establishment of foreign universities in India. Though the bill was first introduced in 2001, during my tenure as MP in the 16th Lok Sabha also, I thought that it will get through, but unfortunately there were some criticism with regard to that bill. But definitely, hopefully, I am of the opinion that such bill will be passed in the coming budget session. Then I request Mr. Alexander to be proactive and see that one of the best universities of US like Harvard, Stanford and MIT will be established in the Hyderabad. So with this opinion, I conclude. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir, for your very inspiring message and also for having laid the direction for the higher education institutions in Telangana. And your suggestion to ATA, I'm sure the Board of Trustees, I must thank the entire delegation of ATA for having attended this program, and then our first thanks to them. I thought, you know, I should propose that in the part of the vote of thanks, first the ATA delegation. Our thanks are to Mr. Eric Alexander, head of the consular section.
తెలంగాణ కౌన్సిల్ ఫర్ హయ్యర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ వారు ఆట రెండు కలిపి ఈ కౌన్సిలేట్ వారిని కూడా ఇక్కడ తీసుకొచ్చి స్టూడెంట్స్ మన స్టడీస్ ఫర్ అబ్రాడ్ స్టడీ డేస్ కనెక్ట్
చెప్పండి.
ఓకే, నా పేరు పరమేష్ భీమరెడ్డి, ఆట ప్రెసిడెంట్. ఈరోజు మేము ఆట అండ్ తెలంగాణ కౌన్సిల్ ఫర్ హయ్యర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్, అదేవిధంగా యుఎస్ కాన్సులేట్ వారి అందరూ కలిపి స్టూడెంట్స్కు అబ్రాడ్ స్టడీస్ మీద అవగాహన తేవడానికి ఇక్కడ ఈ సెమినార్ కండక్ట్ చేయడం జరిగింది. వాళ్ళు ఈరోజు రేపు అక్కడికి వచ్చే పిల్లలు చాలామంది ఇబ్బందుల పాలవుతున్నారు. వాళ్ళు ఇబ్బందులకు గురి కాకుండా ఎలాంటి జాగ్రత్తలు తీసుకోవాలి, అదేవిధంగా కాలేజెస్ ఎలా సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకోవాలి, సో ఇప్పుడు ఈరోజు రేపు ఉన్న భయం ఏంటంటే ట్రంప్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఓ చాలా చేంజెస్ వస్తున్నాయి, చాలా అయిపోతున్నాయని భయపడుతూ అసలు అమెరికాకు వెళ్ళాలా లేదా అనే ఆలోచనలు కూడా వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు. అటువంటివన్నీ నివృత్తి చేయడానికి ఈరోజు ఈ సమావేశం జరిపాము. చాలామంది ఒక 1000 మంది స్టూడెంట్స్ వచ్చారు. ఈ ముప్పగంజ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్కు ఒక 13 కాలేజీల నుంచి స్టూడెంట్స్ వచ్చారు. వీఆర్ యునో ఇట్ వాస్ వెరీ సక్సెస్ఫుల్ ఈవెంట్ అండ్ వీ వుడ్ లైక్ టు థ్యాంక్ యూ తెలంగాణ కౌన్సిల్ ఫర్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అండ్ యుఎస్ కౌన్సిలేట్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ టూ. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
అందరికీ నమస్కారం. నా పేరు భువనేష్ భూజాల. నేను అమెరికన్ తెలుగు అసోసియేషన్ ప్రెసిడెంట్ ఎలక్ట్ని. ఈరోజు December 23 రోజు ముఫకంజా ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్లో ఆట మరియు తెలంగాణ స్టేట్ కౌన్సిల్ ఆఫ్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అలాంగ్ విత్ యునైటెడ్ స్టేట్స్ కౌన్సిలర్ జనరల్ వాళ్ళతో కలిసి ఒక ఎడ్యుకేషనల్ సెమినార్ చేశాము. ఈ సెమినార్కి 30 కాలేజీల నుంచి దాదాపు 500 స్టూడెంట్స్ వచ్చారు. చాలా మంచి సెమినారు. అందరికీ చెప్పేది ఏంటంటే మీకు ఎప్పటికీ ఆట అండగా ఉంటుంది, మీకు ఎలాంటి ఇష్యూస్ వచ్చినా ఆట వరల్డ్.ఓఆర్జీలో మా కాంటాక్ట్ ఉంటుంది. మా ఇమెయిల్ ఈజ్ ఆట హెల్ప్ అట్ ఆట వరల్డ్.ఓఆర్జీ. ఈ వాట్ వీఆర్ ట్రైంగ్ టు టెల్ ఈజ్ దెర్ ఈజ్ నో షార్ట్ కట్ టు ద సక్సెస్. యునో దెర్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ వే విచ్ ఇస్ స్టెప్ బై స్టెప్ టు గో ఇన్ ద రైట్ డైరెక్షన్ అండ్ వీఆర్ దేర్ టు హెల్ప్ యూ. విల్ వర్క్ విత్ ద తెలంగాణ స్టేట్ కౌన్సిల్ ఆఫ్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అండ్ విత్ యూ ఆల్ అండ్ ఆట హ్యాస్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ పీపుల్ టు హెల్ప్ సపోర్ట్ అవర్ స్టూడెంట్ కమ్యూనిటీ. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ అండి. నా పేరు ప్రొఫెసర్ రాజశేఖర్ వంగపాటి, వర్కింగ్ ఎట్ స్టేట్ యూనివర్సిటీ ఆఫ్ న్యూయార్క్, ఎఫ్ఐటి, ఫ్యాషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆఫ్ టెక్నాలజీ ఇన్ న్యూయార్క్. దిస్ సెమినార్ యాక్చువల్లీ అడ్రస్సింగ్ టు ది స్టూడెంట్స్ అండ్ పేరెంట్స్, పర్టికులర్లీ టు ఎడ్యుకేట్ దెమ్ యుఎస్ లోపల ఎడ్యుకేషన్ సిస్టమ్ ఎట్లా ఉంటుంది, ఏమి చేయాలి, అక్కడ అడ్మిషన్ పోవాలంటే ఏమి చేయాలి, అడ్మిషన్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత అక్కడికి యుఎస్కి వచ్చిన తర్వాత కూడా ఏమి చేయొచ్చు, ఏమి చేయకూడదు. ఎందుకంటే అంతమంది చాలా అపోహలు, చాలామంది ఏదో రాంగ్ గైడెన్స్ ఇస్తారు, పోగానే పైసలు సంపాదించవచ్చు అని. అది కాదు, అది చాలా లీగల్లో ఇష్యూస్ ఉంటాయి అక్కడ. అందుకోసం ఈ పాయింట్స్ అన్నీ మేము చెప్తున్నాం ఈ రోజున. అట్లే మన వినోద్ గారు చెప్పినట్టు మేము ఆట విల్ టేక్ ది రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ టు సీ ది గైడింగ్ ది స్టూడెంట్స్, యాక్చువల్లీ ఎట్లా చేయాలి అక్కడ యుఎస్లో వచ్చిన తర్వాత, యుఎస్ వెళ్లే ముందు కూడా ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఏం చేయాలన్న దానికి మేము పూర్తిగా మా సపోర్ట్ చేస్తాం. ఫ్రమ్ ఆట ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అడ్వైజర్గా ప్లస్ పర్సనల్గా యాజ్ అ ప్రొఫెసర్ ఆల్సో ఐ కెన్ అడ్వైజ్ దెమ్. అండ్ ఆల్సో వారు చెప్పినట్టుగా ఇంకా తక్కిన డిస్ట్రిక్ట్లో కూడా విల్ ట్రై టు అవర్ బెస్ట్ టు సీ దట్ వన్, ఇఫ్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఈజ్ పాసిబుల్ దిస్ టైమ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ విల్ ట్రై టు గివ్ ది సెమినార్ సేమ్ థింగ్ వాట్ హీస్ రిక్వెస్టెడ్ యాజ్ డెఫినెట్లీ మేము చేయబోతున్నాము, అది కూడా అని చెప్దామని చూస్తున్నాం అన్నమాట. ద ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ అండి, వారు చెప్పాడు వీడు చెప్పాడు అనకుండా రూల్ ప్రకారంగా వాళ్ళు చేస్తున్నారా లేదా అన్నది, ఏ కాలేజీకి వెళ్తున్నారు ఆ కాలేజీ అక్రెడిటెడా కాదా అండి, అంటే అది వ్యాలిడ్ కాలేజీ, దాని దగ్గర నుంచి డిగ్రీ వస్తే ఆ డిగ్రీ తీసుకున్నాక అది పనికొస్తుందా లేదా, ఇది ఒకటి పేపరేనా లేదా డిగ్రీగా పనికొచ్చి వాళ్ళు మళ్ళీ ఫర్దర్గా H1 కానీ మళ్ళీ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ వస్తుందా లేదా అనేది అది తెలుసుకోవటం ముందు, జాయిన్ అయ్యే ముందే తెలుసుకోవాలి ఆ కాలేజీ వ్యాలిడ్ కాలేజా కాదా అని. అంతేగాని ఎవరో చెప్పారు లేకపోతే ఏదో చేశారు మభ్యపెట్టి ఇక్కడ ఏజెంట్ సంబంధం కొంతమంది చేసి వాళ్ళని ఆ కాలేజీ పంపించిన తర్వాత ఏజెంట్కి ఏమి సంబంధం ఉండదు, కానీ సఫర్ అయ్యేది మన స్టూడెంట్స్, పేరెంట్స్. సో ఇది సైకిల్ అవుతోంది. చాలామంది కేసులు అయినాయి, మీ అందరికి తెలిసిన విషయమే అది, న్యూస్లలో వచ్చినాయి కూడా. ఎందుకు అయినాయి అంటే అది రెండు రకాలుగా ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి. అప్పుడు స్టూడెంట్స్ తోటి ప్రాబ్లం ఉంది, ఎందుకంటే వాళ్ళు షార్ట్ కట్లో పోవాలంది. ఈవెన్ ఎరిక్ అలెగ్జాండర్ కూడా చెప్పినారు ఇవాళ, షార్ట్ కట్స్ చేసినప్పుడు ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వస్తాయని. ఆ షార్ట్ కట్స్ లేకుండా ప్రాపర్గా ఏమి రూల్ ప్రకారం ఏమి చేయాలి అది చేస్తే స్కై ఇస్ ద లిమిట్ అండి. యుఎస్ఏ ప్లేస్ లోపల స్కిల్ ఉంటే మాత్రము ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్కి ఏమీ ప్రాబ్లం లేదు అంటుంటారు ఎన్నో అని, కానీ బట్ స్టిల్ సబ్జెక్ట్ ఉండాలి. సబ్జెక్ట్ ఉంటే మాత్రం గ్యారంటీగా ఇట్ ఇస్ ద బెస్ట్ కంట్రీ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్.